Welcome to Loving Life. My name is Victoria, and today we're going to bake with you this challah bread, breaded challah bread. How beautiful it is! So, let's get started. Put flour into sieve. Now, this sieve is not as fine, so I can add the rest of the dry ingredients here. If you have very fine mesh sieve, don't add the rest of the ingredients. Sieve the flour first. So to the sieve, I'm adding 1/4 cup of sugar. Next, I'm adding yeast. Now, this is very important to use quick rise. Not dry, not anything. If you use dry, it will be a little bit different process and a little bit different way to do it. I'm using quick rise, and quick rise, it's amazing in dry ingredients. You don't need to put them in water and proof first. And that's why I love it, and it gives a little bit different rise to the challah. And I really, really love to use this one. So yeah, I have only measure of 1/2 tablespoon, so tablespoon goes in. So 2 of those.
In general, there are recommendation that not to add yeast on top directly on sugar and salt. But those quick rised yeast are absolutely eliminates those problems altogether. So yeah, I did put the salt next to them. Yeast not on top of them, but if I would put them on top of that, it would be absolutely okay as well. And then sift.
Give it a mix, because you don't want things in one part or not in the other part, so I'm going to mix it all together. Now, the wet ingredients go inside the dry ingredients right away. So 1 egg. Beautiful, with beautiful yolk. This is 1/4 cup of oil. I happen to have grapeseed oil, but you can use avocado oil or any other oil that you have on hand. Canola oil works here. I don't like to use it, but it definitely works here. So 1/4 cup of this one.
Add the water. Now, water needs to be in lukewarm, which is mean that it's about body temperature. When you put your finger inside the water, it needs to be warm. It was easy and nice. That's all it means. So yeah, start mixing and don't add all the water in one time. Start adding, 3/4 of the cup, and then mix and then add a little bit more. I'm adding all the water in the cup because my house is very dry. And it works beautifully every time. But for you, start adding bit by bit, mix, add a little bit more, mix a little bit more, until the dough will be quite wet and sticky.
Okay, when you knead it, you see, you move it a little bit, put a little bit here, and then knead it with your hand. Now, I love to do it in the bowl. I don't mind to do it in the bowl, but flat surface is preferable. So that's what I'm doing until all the flour is incorporated. So I'm trying to take all the flour from all the sides of the bowl.
Knead it for about 7 to 10 minutes or until it's beautiful and shiny.
That's what you want to see in the end. You see how it's glossy and the flour is incorporated. Okay. Now, if it's a little bit too sticky, add about 1 tablespoon of flour. If it's a little bit too dry and you can't get the right consistency, add a little bit of water. That's how it works. And it's very forgiving, actually, recipe. Okay, it needs to be a little bit of still sticky and very, very soft dough. Extremely soft dough.
Just form a ball. Any means you can. As you see, I'm really not professional in this one, and I'm trying to form a ball, but yeah, it works in the end, which is awesome, and that's what I'm going to do.
Like so. I put a little bit here. I have a little bit extra oil, you see, in the cup, which left from the 1/4 cup. It's about, 1/2 teaspoon or so. I'm going to cover all the surface with oil because I want it to not to stick. If you need another half a teaspoon, it's totally okay. Add a little bit, half a teaspoon. Cover it with clean film or put it in the bag and leave it for at least 2 hours or until it double or even double in the half in the size. That's what you want to see. Very a lot of bubbling going on here.
Okay, this was after, I think, about 2 hours, 2 1/4, something like that. And that's how I want it to look. As you see, very big and very nice and warm and wonderful. Now, take it out of the bowl. I'm using oil instead of flour to work with the dough because I don't want to add more flour and make the challah a little bit dense. This way it makes it less dense, but doesn't stick to every surface. As you see, I put oil everywhere. Now divide the dough to 2/3 and 1/3. Each section part to 3 parts. First, take a bigger side braid. Let's make it. Take 1 part, and as you see, I flatten it with my hands and then start to roll it. I roll it in a specific way. You don't have to roll it as I do. You can do just roll. The only thing, they need to be the same size. As you see, I glued the end together and started braiding it. Very simply, 3 parts braid until I'm going to the end. That's all I did. Then take the smaller part and make the same, make the braid. As you see, I didn't do it even beautifully. Just it needs to be looks like another braid. Then take the bigger braid and start rolling it. Yes, like this. Just roll it. It's very beautiful and simple. Then take the smaller braid and roll it as well. As you see, it's by any means perfect or beautiful, but in the end it will be all good and beautiful and perfect. Put the small braid on top of the big braid, and that's it. I transfer it to tray covered with parchment paper and covered it with the bowl that the dough was sitting in. Very simple. Let it stand for about 45 minutes in a warm place and let it grow up almost double in size. Then let's make egg wash. Basically, egg wash is 1 egg and 1 tablespoon of water. That's all is to it. And mix it well. You can use just egg yolk and a teaspoon of water as well, and it will be fine too.
As you see, the challah is doubled inside, or almost doubled inside, which is totally awesome. And now I'm taking the egg, taking the brush, and brushing it very well. It's okay that it's pulling here and there. It's not a problem.
Make sure that you cover it very well on all sides. Cover the challah with your topping of your choice. I love black sesame seeds, as you see here, because they just look beautiful. But you don't have even cover it with anything. Just bake it as it is. Then pop it to preheated oven to 350 Fahrenheit for about 30-35 minutes or until it's puffed and beautiful and golden. And that's it. Let it cool afterwards and enjoy.
I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you will make this and let me know if you did ever, because it's so easy to make. And this recipe actually very versatile. You can make roll with this. You can make pirashki with this and stuff it with something. And it's just amazing. So yeah, try to master this recipe. It's really easy. If I made it, trust me, you can make it. I'm not a baker by any means. So yeah, thank you so very much. And don't forget to subscribe, write me a comment, thumbs up me, go towards your joy and make something fun every day, especially this challah bread. So yeah, see you next time.